Hi everyone, thank you for joining me for this video again. A couple of weeks back, well, it's actually already a couple of months back, it was in July, I was asked by Lear, one of my followers, if I can create a beach scene from the Pensacola beach area. From which he had sent me some pictures as a reference, and I really liked the colors and wished to be there myself. So I decided to give it a go and wanted to do it a bit larger this time. So this is the reason why it took so long to finish this piece, or to create this piece actually, because I needed the space to do this. And as you can see here, it is a bit of a different setting. This is our kitchen table and I just covered the floor to not mess up everything. And yeah, this is the canvas that I am playing with. This is a 90 by 120 centimeter large canvas. And as you can see, it is a reused one. This one already had quite a life cycle. I wanted to do an oil painting on this one first, which I did not do, but I had the initial sketch on there. And so I decided to make a somewhat large pour on this. And I wanted to try if I can make a large swipe with my favorite colors. And in the middle of those both sides, I wanted to add a layer of sand, a separation border, which failed at the first pour. I had some cracks happening there, and so I decided to make another pour over it, which in the end did not turn out as I wanted color-wise and design-wise, because swiping on such a huge canvas, I think it really does not work that well. For me at least, I decided that this size is not worth making a swipe. It just did not work for me. So in the very end, I grabbed my gesso, gessoed over it, so you can just see the pour failure through the gesso a bit, just to give my next step some more grip to the canvas. And this is actually where the new project began. I mixed up my sand, and in case you did not see my other beach videos, I highly recommend you watch them first, because it gives some more information on them. And the sand itself is just some aquarium sand. It is really fine, it is really white, and I added some PVA glue to make a mixture that I can work with. The mixture itself is quite thick, but not that thick that you cannot move it around anymore. So you really do not want to have any bumps in there or to create a really rough texture, unless you want to create this. So I usually make the mixture as thick as possible and as thin to be able to work with. Makes this any sense to you? So actually when I apply to the canvas, I do not want to flow it around everywhere. I just want to stay it where it is, but I want to somewhat level it on its own. So this is actually kind of the consistency that I'm going for. I decide for the design that I want to use as usual. And for this design, I of course try to stick a bit to the reference photos that Lear has sent me. And yeah, I'm basically just put it on there and scratched it around with a palette knife. And when it comes to the edges, this mixture doesn't really flow over the edges from its own unless you make it too thin. So I just painted the edges with the sand as well to make it look more genuine. This works best using your fingers. So just in case, it's fun to mess around with the fingers. When this part was done, it was time to add some of the decoration. And I again used some moss, some mussels, some seashells, an artificial sea star, as you can see, and some decoration stuff that you might find on a beach that might look cool on there. And I thought about adding some of my small flip-flop shoes, which I a couple of times did on my smaller paintings, but I really wasn't sure about this. This one is already out of scale anyways, because the project itself is rather zoomed out and the mussels and seashells are rather zoomed in. If I would have added some of these flip-flop shoes, which are probably smaller than some of these mussels and shells, it would have looked awkward, I think. And I didn't want to put too much of this in there, because there is such a large sand-only area. But I thought if I put something in there, or write something in there, or make hearts or something, it might have looked too overloaded on this picture. So I just decided to make something at the edges, because there is a lot going on for the water area later. So just wanted to see how this one turns out. And when everything was put on there and I was kind of happy with the design, I just had to let it dry. And this takes a while. The sand mixture is rather thick. It's not really, really thick, but about a centimeter at some areas. And as this is glue and there is no way for the glue to dry from underneath because the canvas is super sealed by the failed pores underneath and the gesso that I've applied on there, so it only was able to dry from above. And as I always tell you from these reused canvases, when paint can only dry from above, or in this case the glue, you want to have to dry it slowly because otherwise you risk cracks in your paint. So this one was put aside and I think it took about 2 days until everything was really dry. It of course dries from above earlier than the layers underneath. This is just kind of the deal. I don't know. But you really want to have it cured solid. The water area again was planned to be made with resin. And as I really want to have the resin see-through this time and not really solid colored, I decided to paint the background with the colors that I was going for. This gave me an initial look how the entire thing is going to look, and you can play around with the colors a bit more, because if you have the resin and there is not enough pigment in there and you have a white underlayer, you will see the white through and it will look awkward, and you know, all these things that could happen. And if you have worked in resin already, you know what I mean. So I decided to paint the background in somewhat colors. The Pensacola Beach is really, let's say, greenish turquoise, so I picked my turquoise itself here and painted the background. And when I did this part, the sand area was still wet, so I did this on one go. And as you can see here, everything is really starting to look more polished, so more finished, and you can see how it might look in the very end. So this was something, for myself, really important to see if the entire thing works out. When the time came to apply the resin, there was not really so much magic that I did. So you've seen me do this in a couple of more videos on a smaller scale, of course, but basically I just mixed my resin. If you have a new canvas or better an MDF board for this kind of artwork, you can of course tape the edges to prevent the resin from flow over the edges, which would not have worked for me this time here. As this canvas is already reused twice and gessoed over, if I would have added the tape around these areas and would have removed the tape in the end, I would have ripped the color apart and it would have looked just awkward, and I would have ended with having partially white ripped off paint edges, or perhaps even the canvas itself would have been ripped apart. So this is something I did not want to have, and so I left the edges as they were to allow the resin to flow over. This of course means to be more careful, and the resin that I was using here is a rather thin one because of the amount that I was going to use. And I needed a resin that cures in about 45-ish minutes because I needed some time to work with. So it took a while. I mixed it up and mixed three different colors, which is a metallic turquoise, which is my base color here, which I wanted to use, a darker blue color, for which I used the resinate pigments again, and a pure turquoise acrylic color, which has no metallic pigments in there anyways. And then of course the white, which I was going to need for the waves. I applied the resin and really only made a thin layer of it, not have too much of the product flowing around there and moving and creating awkward shapes. Because you know, on such large canvases, you don't have an even surface. You will have bumps in there and areas where the canvas is a bit more saggy and everything is going to flow around. And when you play with the resin and make some of these highlights and waves and such, and everything moves around uncontrolled, you might have a really awkward looking result in the end. So this was something I wanted to avoid. So this was a really thin layer of the resin, which was enough to give it a resin look, and then played around until I had the result that I wanted to have. And once I was happy with the design, I just let it be, did not touch it anymore for the next couple of hours until everything was set. The good thing with this cheaper, thinner resin is that it is curing pretty quickly, so after about 4 hours it was already ready to touch and I could stand it upright to give me some more space here. And then I just let it be again for I think 1 or 2 days until everything was completely cured and solid hard. So the resin itself, even if it's dry to the touch, it takes a bit more time to completely cure, so just let it be. And this is actually everything that I did. I will in the end show you some more pictures which I did outside. in sunlight so that you can get the real colors of them. And I also made a small video clip as well where I hover over this picture and show you how it looks in reality. Yeah, so that's it. I really hope you liked the video. Lear, I hope you liked the result and it pleases you. I hope I did a good job. I really liked the end result myself. And I honestly hope that someone wants to get it for his or her home. So yeah, that's it. If you liked it, please make sure to give me a thumbs up and leave a comment if you liked it or if you have any questions whatsoever. As usual, all my social media links are also linked in the video description down below. If you want to adopt something from my original artwork, you can head over to my Etsy shop and have a look at the available items. Or if you want to commission me for realistic, abstract, acrylic pouring, resin artwork, geode, whatever, you can of course contact me and we can talk that through. Would be happy, of course. So yeah, again, if you liked it, please also make sure to subscribe to my channel if you have not done already and share with everyone that might want to have a look at this. And all my other videos, of course. So once more, thank you so much for watching, thank you for your time, and other than that, I hope to see you in my next videos. Have a great day. Bye bye.